Hey, what's up there, YouTube? This is Crazy Hawkman. And today, can't see me better. And today, I'm going to show you my top six or seven Yugioh cards I love, especially from this tin can that I put all my cards in. Also, please check out my channel, subscribe for more Yugioh showings of cards. As of right now, I'm going to choose at least.
Got your card.
They can't see me, dude.
What?
The YouTube can't see me, dude. My top favorite Yu-Gi-Oh cards. Got one. I'm not just doing. I'm actually doing monster cards. Two of them are tied for first, so and it's just not gonna let you know that you too. I'm not gonna exclude any dragons that are my favorites, so just bear with me. I'm gonna go for 7 favorite. And sorry for all you dark magician. Yeah, sorry. Buster Blader fans, spoiler, he's I'll show you. Number 7 top pick is Buster Blader. One reason I choose him is he defeats all dragons. And he goes up, let's see here. Warrior Effect. It's also a rare card in the Battle City packs. He gains 500 points for each dragon type monster in the field or is in the graveyard. See, that's his best effect. And see, I should have done this a while ago, I should have put this. Like, X Underground members X had their own thing of their favorite cards and stuff like that. So that goes back in the pile. Okay, my number My number six is Winged Dragon on Spear Mode. I like it, it's because, well, it's number six to me. And I should say top seven. One reason why is because, I guess, it's not just my favorite of all the Yu-Gi-Oh cards, but listen to this. You can't special summon, except for, requires three tributes on either side of the field. Normal summon on the side of the field. Cannot be normal set. Then shift the control to this card. Owner during the end phase of the next turn cannot attack your opponent. Cannot target this card when for attacks or by card effects. You can tribute this card to special summon. One, Winged Dragon of Ra from your hand or deck, ignoring the summoning conditions. And if you do, the attack and defense becomes 4,000. Good thing I put Winged Dragon Raw Spear Mode in this bike video of my favorites. Okay, Randy at the top five spot, Jizno. He destroys all traps, your opponents, and also your traps too. Unless you had this one brain thingy with you, but I can't remember the name of the spell card, so yeah. But anyways, he's a good monster. Good attack, 2400 attack, 1500 defense. And stuff like that usually don't come around as a rare. Like the other Buster player had a rare holographic name like this. But the Winged Dragon on a Spear Mode issue was an ultra rare. So. Okay. Sorry, it's not just for dragons. Ready to get my number five spot? She's a magician. I can do that. Magician girl. Dark magician girl. She's got a good effect. She goes up for 300 points for each dark magician or dark magician on a black chaos inside the graveyard. Just magician of life. Their YouTube? Sorry, I don't have a computer thing right here or thing generated. But maybe something in the future. And also, she will be good enough on the eyes for mostly guys that want to drool over her, especially me. But if she was uncensored, no. That's my number five spot. Oh, and yes, these cards are sleeved. Right about number three spot. Since I made its partner, and to number five. the Winged Dragon Rock. Super rare. Got this in the mail a couple of months ago, a couple of years ago. Something that I had luck pulling out the Winged Dragon Rock Spear Mode. I have a Battle City pack, but now I got Winged Dragon Rock. If I would have pulled Winged Dragon Rock Phoenix before, Immortal Phoenix, then yeah. But I love Winged Dragon Rock as next to the ultimate guy in the universe, which is Cyber-0 or whatever I'm watching up here. Yeah, X Underground Members X. Yeah, I like that guy. He's cool, and also simply unlucky. I kind of like him, but he needs to be more quieter. Like most of us, like, you know, that wants to get logged for super secret, ultra, whatever rare card there is. I'm all up for just being quiet. Yay! And one reason I put this as number 3 is because there's some issues about it. All he wants, if you summon him from the graveyard, he goes out for one turn. Or if you summon him, you get a sacrifice 3 monsters. I like that. So, he's my number 3 spot. Well, I should say, I do have some ultimate endings to this. But not right now. But not today. I have my favorite dragon right here as number 2. Red Eyes Black Dragon. He's a cool looking character. He should have been an ultimate beast to destroy Blue Eyes, but instead, they might have a level 7 monster with 2400 attack. That's not even enough to destroy Dark Magician. Though it's not in my favorite as of right now. Maybe next month as of today. Red Eyes is my favorite, second favorite right now. But they should make a fusion monster for him called Red Eyes Ultimate Dragon. Not to get confused with Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon. I like Blue Eyes Ultimate Dragon, I think he's cool, but I think they should make a cousin for that, like, you know, Red Eyes Ultimate Dragon. I think that makes a lot of people sense for Red Eyes. Some people believe that cards like should be 3 and should be as a monster together, like him, instead of like Black Skull Dragon or Red Eyes Archfiend Skull Dragon or whatever that Skull Dragon is for. I think it should be Red Eyes Ultimate Dragon, 3500. Okay, this card I pulled out of my first Battle City pack, out of every card I pulled, like Spear Mode, the Gizno, the Dark Magician Girl, I think this should have number 1 spot. Blue-Eyes White Dragon. I think he's cool that it has his ultimate ego, which is ultimate Blue-Eyes Ultimate Dragon. Also, his shining counterpart, which is Shining Blue-Eyes, Blue-Eyes Shining Dragon. I think he could have been an ultimate. Not an ultimate rare or ulti rare, but just an ultimate dragon of destruction. But also, I think about it. Now I think about it, it's just, come on, dude. Come on, be more assertive towards Raz being Hulk from the Dragon. And also was becoming number one, but no. There's no way I could do that. But Raz and Buzz should have been an ultimate pair of destruction. Boys, as well as good cards for the original show of Yu-Gi-Oh! And part of Yu-Gi-Oh!'s. I think it's like a cool looking card for Kaiba to have. Or for Joey if he could ever be. Which is kind of awesome. And Kaiba would have put up his red up. Was that means Joey would have had during the episode where he was battling Kaiba in the Battle City Finals after they were lost. But instead, Kaiba won that one with Crush Card Virus. Maybe next time I'll do another top 10 or top 7. Next time I'm gonna go for top 10. Yu-Gi-Oh! Trap cards next week. If you could, let's just put it next week. I put it in my thing. And yeah, my phone actually. But anyways, maybe also next week I might do a top 10 sequel monster thing. I don't know. Depends on how well my busy schedule is. And stuff like that. So I'm sorry there, YouTube, or anybody else on YouTube. I have not done a favorites thing since I started YouTube, and I'm real sorry. So basically, forgive me. I love you guys. I'll do this one next week. If not, oh well. Like the button. Like button, comment, and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys later. On, if anybody in my family member gets this video on YouTube, I'm sorry, it's like 18 minutes long. I try to do it as best as short as I can. So sorry. Cool. Hit that like button, subscribe.